Welcome back to Salute to Education. I'm Dennis Morgino here with Dr. Randy Ward, the County Superintendent of Schools. We saw that piece on Reality Changers, which is an incredible program to try to get kids to who never really had thoughts of college to start thinking about it, going it, succeeding at college in higher education, at least completing their education through high school. Do we not know how bad, does the general public not know how bad this problem is in our county schools?
We've known for 30 years that public education in this country is in trouble. It was a report called Nation at Risk, 1983. And we talked about if we don't get our act together, we're gonna have a large population of students and then becoming adults who are unproductive, who will be a drain versus a help on society. So we've known this a long time, and we've gone through a few cycles of the things to try and deal with it. But we really, as a country, haven't had the resolve to actually take it on full head on. And so programs like the Reality Changers takes the local program head on.
And even the
but it's more than just thinking you can go to college, and it's more than just going and being successful, but the preparation to get there and be successful.
And the motivation and even the thought in your head as a kid coming from a family where no one has ever finished high school.
Yes.
So how do you go about starting to make that change? Going into a gang.
Than what you see. Than what you see in your local community. And even in your own family, than what you see.
Yes. So how do you go about starting to make that change?
It happens throughout the community in terms of instilling what it means to be an adult, how successful do you want to be, and how do you plan to be successful? And so even though you're in a place like I was where, you know, no one, my parents hadn't gone to college, you know, my neighborhood wasn't about to go to college, none of my friends talked about college, still you have to think that you need to find a place that will prepare you.
This sounds as though it's an entire community that must come together. And so what's your role as an educator and the folks in the districts that you supervise? How do they try to engage the rest of the community? Because this sounds like it's more than one operation.
It's a community event to get a child from birth to graduating from college and being a successful and having a successful career, or from high school and going into a successful career, because as you know, you don't always need college to get into a good career.
Good vocational. But you got to graduate from high school.
And you have to have the skills you
need.
That's right. But you have to have the skills you need to be able to do the work. So it takes a belief throughout the community, but also you have to prepare teachers. And quite frankly, our teachers and education system has to believe in certain types of children.
Explain that.
If you do not believe in children, then you don't go the extra mile. Reality Changers show that when you believe in children, they will go the extra mile. But if you don't, then they won't as well. If you are up here, they will get to it. But if you're down here, they'll go that far as well. They'll stay there. So part of our challenge is this achievement gap, which is not only the achievement gap, and I'm not blaming educators. The achievement gap has to do with a lot of factors in family, home environments, all of those pieces, income, et cetera, a lack of literacy in the home, all of those pieces. But the most powerful impact to decreasing the achievement gap is the teacher. The teacher is a key factor and can overcome many, if not all, I would say not all, but many of those factors that cause our students to underachieve. So when you get that in play, and that is about motivation, idealism, but also preparation for urban kids and urban issues.
Dr. Randy Ward, as always, thank you very much. We'll be right back.